ऑलमोस्ट एवरी वन दैट आई हैव शोन दिस फोटो टू हैज आस्क्ड मी और अज्यूम्ड दैट दिस इज फोटोशॉप्ड. नाउ यू नो इट्स नॉट. ओके, पार्ट थ्री ऑफ स्टोरीज बिहाइंड फोटोज. सो आई एम हेयर अगेन विद वन मोर ऑफ माई वेरी वेरी फेवरेट फोटोज to take you a little behind the scenes on what went through to get that one shot, which is the one that you are seeing on the screen. But yes, this is just the result. A lot happened to get to this point of taking this picture. Let me take you to the journey of how it all happened. So I'm going to start from the very start. Once upon a time when travel was possible, we packed our bags for a very adventurous shoot to Ladakh from Delhi. With us were Vidit and Aparna, who are absolutely amazing people. We had a chance to meet and to photograph their wedding. We started our journey early in the morning and we had, I think, a 7 or 8 day trip planned to Ladakh, because that's the minimum that you should plan if you want to cover like the major places of Ladakh, and especially if you want to spend some time and plan a shoot around that. So we started in the morning and I'm just taking you through some of the random photos that we took through the journey. It's possible to go by road also, but we chose to fly just to save time. And very soon we were greeted by the majestic mountains, as I like to call the Himalayas from Ladakh. So I'm going to cut short through all of our journey that went to make other photos, and I'm going to concentrate only on this one. So I'm going to take you straight to day number 3 that we planned for Pangong. I think it takes around 5 and a half hours of travel through road from the main Leh city to Pangong, and we started early in the morning because the plan was to reach there before the sunset so that the roads are safer to travel, and also we all can rest for a night before we go to the shoot next morning. Just taking you through the journey of what we all saw when we were on the road from Ladakh, from the Leh city to the Pangong. So taking you through the journey, this is how the road trip looked like in bits and pieces. And of course, the sky is amazing, the light is amazing, the Himalayas, the mountains are amazing. And soon after, around 5 hours later, we were greeted by the amazing Pangong. So we, as per plan, we reached there before the sunset. We rented a tent and 3 bags, and me and Rituraj just went out to the Pangong just to see the light, where it all falls, at what time, what shadows come, so that Vidit and Aparna don't face a lot of problems when we are shooting tomorrow, because we were also there for the first time. And whenever we are with people we are photographing, we make sure that we have done our homework. The trouble was, walking on those roads were really hectic. Like, if you the oxygen levels were really low and you had to breathe 4 times of what you were breathing in the city or wherever you lived. I think this was the guest house, yes. So this was the place we rented for the night. And even though the distance between here and Pangong was not much, but it was really tiring just to walk. Anyhow, so we kind of reached there and we spent the whole evening just enjoying the Pangong, listening to the water flowing, seeing the light, seeing the mountains, and basically also planning the shoot for the next day. So that was it. But when we came back to the place that we rented, we thought that, dude, we are not going to witness the night at Pangong again. Like, we were going back by tomorrow afternoon so that we can travel by the day, so we cannot miss the night sky. And ट्रिविया टाइम, इन पैंगोंग यू कैन सी द मिल्की वे गैलेक्सी बाय योर नेकेड आई. यू कैन जस्ट लाई डाउन एंड यू कैन जस्ट सी द स्टार्स इन द स्काई, द गैलेक्सी इन द स्काई. इट्स जस्ट, इट जस्ट कैन नॉट बी एक्सप्लेन इन वर्ड्स. यू हैव टू एक्सपीरियंस दैट. आई एक्चुअली प्लान्ड अ स्पेसिफिक शॉट for this location. I had an idea in mind and I wanted to capture the whole galaxy the way it was there, with some twist and with a little finesse of something, some flair, something just to add it to the value of the photo. So what we tried was a concept called light painting. For those of you who know the camera terms, we basically keep the shutter at a very, very low value so that all the light that is being captured through that exposure time gets captured in the photo. So we had this idea of capturing the whole night sky with Udit and Aparna somewhere in the photo and with some light painting. So I'm going to take you to the failed attempts to the final photo that you are here for. This was our first attempt. It's always our test shot. So I always build my frame across three key features: light, frame and emotion. So we were there testing the light and frame, and this light what you see behind is actually Rituraj standing with kind of a high power torch, and we folded a canvas around the torch in a circular manner, and we basically elongated the torch so that the light doesn't scatter but basically becomes like a light tube, and we can wave it in the air and it gives us some shape and some sense of what was going around. So this is actually this is Vidit, this is Aparna, and in the background is my friend Rituraj, who's trying to create a shape so that they are basically separated from the background. Otherwise the background is black, there is no light there, and they are also black, so they are going to blend in the background and you can see nothing. So that is the reason behind we tried doing this concept. And so we tried a couple of times. This was another failed attempt. And then we thought, initially we thought that we will just put the light behind them, but then when I was there I had an idea that why not do something like this. This is a hugely failed attempt, but then you have to take all those bad photos to get to that superhero one. So I asked Rituraj, why not just run around in a semicircle around them and basically with the light torch on and try to create some sort of shape. So here what is happening is Rituraj is coming from this side, running towards them, stopping here, waving the light around them, behind them, and then exiting from the frame from the right, which is what you can see in this photo. If you see, this is Rituraj, who's kind of visible on the left. He starts from here, goes here, waves the light here, again wait for some time, and then exits the frame from here. Now my frame and my light was sorted. I was sure this is what I was going to capture, because we can see Rituraj here. That means that my shutter speed was not low enough and I had to make it even lower to get a clean frame. The bad thing about that is nobody can stand still for 30 seconds. Nobody. You will move some sort or the other in some way and that will ruin the photo. So the only request I made to Vidit and Aparna was to basically stand still for 30 seconds. It was really tough, mainly because of the kind of temperature that was there. I think it was minus something and the wind was very, very chilly. But these guys did a great job of standing still. So I had my frame, I had my light, and then I had my emotion there. So this is the final picture that we came with. Of course, there is a little adjustments of contrast and there is a little kind of finesse that's added in the post, which is what we do for every photo. But then if you look in all these failed attempts, this is actually what was happening there. And almost everyone that I have shown this photo to has asked me or assumed that this is photoshopped. Now you know that it's not. A lot of work went behind it and went to get this photo done. We also made a portrait frame of the same environment, which is this. So now you know how this photo was created, and no Photoshop, it was actually there. And if I can take you a little more behind the scenes of this photo, like what we were feeling when we were doing this, I'll show you this picture. So this is what happens when you do a shoot in Ladakh. You have to work, you have to come back, you have to take the oxygen, then you have to go again, then you have to work, then you have to go back again and take oxygen. And I hope this was interesting enough for you to know what went behind clicking this picture. And till next time, goodbye from all of us.